Good morning. How's everyone this morning? If you can see right there, I have the lantern on. So I'm going to ask you how you are this morning. And yesterday we did SLS and what color would you like? If I was to pick a color, I would pick blue. What color would you pick? And why are you feeling that way? And is it a positive, negative, or neutral? Yesterday, this is how many people we had were able to ask. Most people are doing pretty good. And a lot of the reason was because we were able to see each other. So hopefully we'll be able to do that with other people. That would be so good. Today is Day of Pink, and it's anti-bullying and a celebration of diversity. So I do have a pink heart on. I didn't actually know it was until I started to listen to the news. But yeah, if you have pink, you could wear pink today. I forgot to do the comic yesterday, so I'm going to do two. So I'm going to start with one, this one here, and it's Lucy and Charlie Brown. And Lucy says, "Hey, Charlie Brown, I've got your mound all fixed up. Well, what do you think? It looks great. Go ahead, try it out." "Of course, it needs a little packing down." Charlie Brown fell through the dirt. Have you ever done that? Gone somewhere and you've fallen into the dirt or the snow? Sometimes that will happen in the snow. It's not all packed down, so you fall down. That's happened to me before. So, what is the day today? You're not going to believe this. I just saw it on the news. On CTV Morning. They're telling people what the day is and showing them. They're doing just what we do. What is today? Today is Wednesday. And what is the number? That's right, it's 8. And what month is it? January, February, March, and April. And the year 2020. So there's our April in 2020. So today is Wednesday, April 8th, 2020. I didn't say March today. The news. So, a lot of people, 4 million people applied to the CERB, which is assistance right now. So, you apply online if you have a certain birthday, and 4 million people have done it already. And it hasn't sounded like there has been very many glitches or an overload where the system shut down. So, that's really good. And Trudeau talked about that yesterday. Ford was talking and he was talking about masks, and he assured Ontario that masks were on the way from 3M and there was nothing to worry about because they were going to definitely make sure that Canada had their masks. And there was good news in China today. Wuhan, where the virus started, is opening up trains and travel. So if you pass their health requirements, you're able to travel again. So that's nice. Things are opening up again. And I'm going to do a second comic so I don't forget the comic for today. That's another baseball one. It would be baseball season, wouldn't it? Charlie Brown liked his base likes his baseball. It says, "Well, the rain may have washed away my pitcher's mound, but now it's back in shape. I'm up here like I used to be, up here on the old mound, throwing my old fastball." And pow! What we need around here is a little more rain. So do you see what happened to poor Charlie Brown? Whoever was up to bat hit his ball and it hit right straight at him. Poor Charlie Brown. Well, it's raining today, isn't it? Let's look at the weather. I'll go on my phone. If I look outside, it's raining. I only have my raincoat and my rubber boots to go outside with Ollie today. Now, it actually says cloud. And that's the Blue Mountains. Doesn't really say rain today, but it was raining this morning. And Meaford is the same, cloudy, a little bit cooler. But it was raining this morning, for sure. So we still will have to wear our rain boots. Ollie likes to go where the mud is. She likes to go in the water and in the mud. Some of the birds that I got to see yesterday, I saw two at my new bird feeder. It was the downy woodpecker and a chickadee. And the other bird that I saw outside my other window was a mourning dove. And it was getting some seeds from the evergreen tree that's outside my window. I was going to ask you, have you ever done any crossword puzzles or word searches since you've been home? Or Sudoku? I've been doing those every day. And I got my dad doing them. And even my sister, too. She said she was doing a crossword puzzle. So it's a good way to pass the time. And I like to do the easy ones. But my dad unfortunately picked a book that was for all-stars. And he said it's challenging, so he sent me some so I could give them a try. So that should be fun. The other thing I wanted to do was I wanted to show you Office 365, if it would come up. Now, it might not look so good. So this is where you go if you get onto Office 365. And on the side here is where you find our group. So I'm going to go to our group. I'm going to scroll down. And it's called GBCS-KMMSEM2. And when I click on it, it goes to this group. And you see at the top, it says KMMSEM2-01, private group. And there's 20 members, so everybody is a member. And that's where I've been sending some emails. And if you go to Files, which is there, you'll see it says send email, and right next to it is a little piece of paper, and that is group files. If you click on group files, it gives you all of the things that I've been sending. And if you scroll down, it has folders that for each period. And in each period, I've put work related to our period that we were doing at school. So for instance, if you click on period A, we've been doing the newspaper. So I have topics we discuss in the newspaper, period A communications, and a homework log sheet so that you can say, I did this today in regards to reading. It also has the ABCs of art booklet because in period A we also did art. So those things are things that you can print at home so you have work to work on. And then if you go back, you can go to other file folders and I have other things in there for you. I'll tell you what I have. So in period B, it takes a little bit to go back. That's okay. And to load back up. So I've hit the file folder period B, and I've given you some math work. You got some math work in there. And I also put in some activities like bocce ball rules. I've put a list of the different activity bins that we did. I've also put in sun salutation and physical activities that we've done, like physio stuff. I've got some money math, remember our rolling the dice worksheets. Okay, so that's another spot for you to get some work. And then Miss Woodhouse is going to put some stuff in her period C. And then I'll show you what's in period D. So once again, I'll show you what it looks like. So I've hit files in the groups, and you've got all of the different file folders, and I'm going to go to period D next, and what we did in period D was SLS, so I've given you the SLS worksheet, but I've also given you the evaluation sheet, so if your parents want to see all the different steps we do, I've given you the happy and sad smiley face, and I've given you a daily journal if you'd like to do a journal on what you did in the day. So that's period D. So everybody, even if you have an iPad, can access those file folders in that group. So then if we go to Teams, which looks like this, it's purple, that's where we can do, it's the same idea. That's not a very good picture, is it? Except in Teams, it has the capability of doing the video chat. And if you go right to the bottom, there's a little video camera. And if you click the video camera, a camera comes up. And then you can join the conversation. You can see me in there. Because it's taking a picture of my computer. So that's how we've been doing the video chats. I know it is overwhelming and it seems like a lot. So you just do what you can do. And we just can do our best, right? So even if you could get one worksheet out from the files, maybe do a little bit of art today, do sun salutation. I think that's what I'm going to start to do, sun salutation every day. I don't think I'm getting enough like stretching and walking, because when we're at school, we're walking around all the time and moving. And then when we're at home, we do a lot of sitting. So that is my going to be my goal, is to do the sun salutation today. Okay, so I just wanted to, I know that was probably also confusing because I'm showing you different computers, but I thought I would mention that you can access some worksheets in the groups. You don't have to have the ISO 10.0 for the iPads. And you can access that on your phone as well, and you could print things off. And I just also wanted to show you what the Teams looks like. So we're reading about, continuing to read about dogs. And Ollie is here today, so that's nice. Just gonna find my spot. Yes, yesterday we were talking about bones and if your dog eat bones. Oh, I almost forgot before we read. Oops, ouch. See, I told you it hurts. Does anybody know what that is? It has thorns. It's a rose. It's a dried rose. And inside would be the seeds. Let's see if I can get some. You won't be able to see them, but. Ooh, it's very picky. You have to be careful. Oh, yeah, there's the seeds. Can you see them in my hand? Yep, there's a whole bunch of little seeds. Yeah, so that was a rose. And in the winter, they dry up, and then the seeds are still in there. I got seeds everywhere. So, my object for tomorrow, do you know what this is? Okay. I'm not even going to give you a hint. I'm just going to show it to you. Do you know what that is? But I'm not telling you today. I'll tell you tomorrow. That's the one thing. And my sound. I will tell you the sound at the end, but I don't tell you the object, do I? Okay, you ready? You know what that is? It's macaroni and cheese. Did you guess it? And of course, that was also Max. He's tried to scare me. Some of you do that too at school, don't you, to me? Yes, you do. That's okay. But yeah, that was macaroni and cheese. You know that sound when you pour the noodles out of the box? I thought you'd like that. Okay, back to the dogs. Did I forget anything else? I'm a little. There's so many things on my list, sometimes I forget. So here we go. Some of the dog's senses are superior to those of many other animals. In sense of smell, particularly, is almost without comparison. Some breeds, especially those in the hunting and tracking classes, have an extremely acute sense of smell. The bloodhound, often used by police for tracking, can follow a trail that is invisible to other dogs. One sniff of a person's clothing or shoes is enough. The bloodhound can then often track that person for miles across streets, fields, and mountains. An excellent sense of smell is one reason why wolves can silently follow their prey through the forest on the darkest night. Sensing every twist and turn. Sorry, I just got distracted because I don't see my... Oh, there it is. I didn't see my video camera, which I always see. So I'm hoping we're still videotaping. So that's a... We'll stop there because the next one is talking about hearing. But we'll stop there on its sense of smell. And if you notice, that's what dogs do when they meet another dog. They smell the dog, right? Okay, and the last thing I have is a song, and I heard this person's name on the news this morning, and he's from Vancouver, and his name is Sean Hook, and he's been doing concerts. Every Thursday, he does a live concert online.
You know my courage, my sword and shield, grace under pressure, my wall of steel. I was a stone weighing us down. You were the angel I chained to the ground. I miss the way you undress. I miss your hair on my chest. Can't stop this bleeding, can't stop believing. I'm missing the sound of your heart beating.
Do you know that song? I know that song, but I didn't know that was Sean Hook from Vancouver. So that was neat. Okay, so I think that's all I have for today. I hope everyone's well. I miss you, and I hope you have a great day. And maybe try one new thing today. Okay, bye.